Christmas.
Dressed as the ghost of Christmas present, Jackie Lambie today laid out some hard Yuletide truths.
Those belts are tightening. We're feeling, $8 yesterday for a cauliflower down here. I paid.
The government's trying to give us at least a little cost of living relief this silly season.
A cap on gas, a state cap on coal, some household assistance, and ongoing investment in cleaner and cheaper energy.
The cap will reduce bills by some $230.
What the cap's supposed to do is separate the domestic gas and electricity markets from the global market, which are being affected by overseas prices.
The world is in an energy crisis not seen since the 70s, and local producers are posting record profits.
These companies are doing incredibly well on global markets. We support the industry, but we don't want these high prices to hollow out local industries and put extra pressure on families.
The opposition has rubbished the plan.
They're taking gas out of the system, not putting more in, which is going to drive prices up. We're not supporting that sort of witch's brew of disaster.
Just so ill thought out. It is crazy. The way you reduce price is to increase supply.
The Greens up in arms about the idea taxpayers could foot the bill to compensate energy producers.
These big gas corporations pay next to no tax. They often get their gas for free. And now the coal corporations have even got their hand out for compensation from the public purse.
There is nothing in the legislation to provide any compensation.
Independent David Pocock's refusing to support the bill without tougher climate measures. But other crossbenchers say they've got no choice.
I don't want to not support it, that's for sure. If it's going to give relief, certainly we have intentions of supporting that on Thursday.
Senators will have to answer to Australian families and Australian businesses for higher power prices next year if they don't support this.
So will Aussie families get the gift of stable power prices this Christmas? Or is a lump of coal all we can expect?
I really want to see Jackie Lambie wear that in Parliament. Greens leader Adam Bandt is one of those threatening to withhold support for the bill, and he joins us now. Thank you very much for your time.
Thanks, Holly.
So Jim Chalmers today said that a vote against this bill is a vote against lower power prices for Australians and their families. That's a fairly strong sort of statement. Why would you want to stand against that?
Well, we've been calling for power bills to be lowered for a long time. The coal and gas corporations are taking this country for a ride. They're profiteering off the back of people's pain. We've been calling for an electricity bill freeze at pre-crisis levels for 2 years. If we put a windfall tax on these big coal and gas corporations, we could fund that and also have enough money left over for people to do things like get off expensive dirty gas, trade in their expensive gas appliances for ones that run on cheaper and cleaner renewable electricity. So we're going to go to Canberra in the next couple of days to fight to improve this package so that people end up with more money in their pocket. We don't support using public money to compensate coal and gas corporations. The people shouldn't be compensating coal and gas corporations. It should be the other way around.
But so you're saying that we shouldn't be needing to compensate energy producers, right? However, we just heard from the Prime Minister Anthony Albanese there on radio this morning, and it doesn't sound like that is the plan.
Well, over the weekend, the government was saying that, or there were reports that there was close to $500 million in compensation for some of these coal producers. And it may be that they do it through means other than this legislation, or that's one of the things that we're trying to find out from the government and get a bit more detail about this. Look, we want to be in a position for this to be to deliver more for people, to put some money into the pockets of renters, for example, so that renters could do things like go and get better gas appliances, get rid of their gas appliances rather, and move over to cheaper and cleaner electric, get solar batteries, many of the things that renters often don't get at the moment. So we're going to be fighting for the amount of money that goes to households to be lifted and the amount of money that goes to these big coal and gas corporations to be reduced.
They're all good things down the track, but we all are worried now about the bill that we're going to get in January or February or March. So they're right, are they not, about the supply argument, Adam, that if you keep more supply in the system, the price will go down. What's the Greens' solution here? I mean, if you take gas out, it'll go up.
We don't have a supply problem in this country. We've got more gas than people know what to do
with. The problem is going over. You've got to have people to go and search for it and sell it.
No,
if you're going to whack the companies, they're not going to do that.
No, it's getting sold off overseas at very high prices by these big multinationals that make billions of dollars and they pay no tax.
What's it do to our sovereign risk if you tear up those contracts?
Well, they're getting their gas for free in many instances.
They're not getting it.
The Australian people own this. They should be paying their fair share of tax. We could use that money to drive.
How are we going to get the bills down in January? What's the Greens' solution to that. Right now,
put a windfall tax on these big corporations, freeze power bills for two years.
Power bills?
Yeah, and you'd end up with an extra $25 billion left in the kitty to do things like give money to people to go and trade in their dirty and expensive gas appliances and switch over to electric.
But it sounds like you're not going to have any agreement with the government. If you're sitting in that corner and they're in this corner, you're not going to come together between now and Thursday.
Look, we just saw at the federal election a record number of people vote for the Greens, and we've got more seats in Parliament, including balance of power in the Senate, and part of the reason that people put us there is to push the government to do better on climate, to stop propping up the coal and gas corporations and instead ask them to make their fair share, and to do better for people, including renters, people on low incomes, people who are doing it tough. We did that on their electric car legislation, we did it on their climate legislation, we pushed them and we got a better deal. That's what we're going to do when we go back.
Can I just say, the problem I hear with what you're proposing is, if I'm running an energy company and you do that, all you're basically doing is giving me the green light to pull supply, because you're going to say, well, we're going to freeze electricity bills. And I'm going to say, well, OK, if you're not going to allow us to charge the market rate, then we're going to adjust our supply. We're going to put less into the system because that way we still get what would be the relevant market rate at that level of supply. We had a dry run of this in Victoria, didn't we? And remember that there was a moment where Victoria had a power crisis, and it was precisely for that reason.
Look, I think electricity is an essential service. I don't think it should be something that these big multinational corporations are making billions of dollars of profit off the back of everyday people's pain, paying next to no tax, and then threatening to pull up stumps and go somewhere else whenever we decide to take them on. It's time to take on these big corporate
giants. You can say
you
don't like that, but that's actually the market. So your proposal doesn't address that, does it? I mean, if you did your proposal in this market, that's what you would get. It's just not...
No, I disagree. Like, we've got the solutions right now. In a country that's blessed with renewables like Australia, we've got the technology, we've got batteries. It's just a cost barrier for many people. A lot of people just can't afford to do these things. Like, a lot of the people on low incomes that the government and us want to help, they've got these old gas heaters that are running, right? They're expensive to run. And once this 12-month price cap ends, they're going to continue to be expensive to run. We're saying, let's step in, get those people off gas with a bit of government help, get small businesses off gas.
That's way down the road in the green Nirvana land. We're talking about next January.
What I'm really worried about is that the government puts in a temporary price cap, and in 12 months' time, if the war in Ukraine's not resolved, or these big corporations are still trying to fleece us, bam, the price goes back up in 12 months' time. And I want to make sure that at the end of that 12 months, we've looked after renters, we've looked after low-income earners, people who are doing it tough, we've helped them get out of expensive, dirty gas, get onto cheap and clean renewables, so that, because then you don't just deliver a 12-month reprieve, you deliver cheaper power bills for year after year after year. And at the moment, there's nothing in the government's plan that's going to help people actually have cheaper power bills for life.
So, Adam, yes or no, will you be voting for this?
We're going to meet tomorrow afternoon as a party room, all our MPs, to look at it. Our approach between now and then is to work with the government to try and improve this package. As I say, that's what we managed to do their climate bill. That's what we managed to do with their electric car bill. Right now, we're talking to the government. We're getting detail. We had a good briefing this afternoon. We're looking forward to seeing the legislation, and we'll look at this in good faith. I know the opposition is just saying, no, it's all a mess. They don't want to do anything. We think power bills are rising too fast, hurting people too much to take that irresponsible approach. So we'll sit down and try and improve this package.
We are out of time. I hope you've enjoyed this interview, Tom. Your head has been used. It's been amazing. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thanks very much.